as a welcome to all of you, the participants of the Advanced Meditation course, as well as every one of you tonight, we have prepared a welcome dance, a traditional Balinese welcome dance.
Tugas ini masih belum selesai. Di sini, mari kita bersama-sama melakukan ikrar kembali untuk menjadi duta perdamaian dan melakukan bakti kami untuk perdamaian dalam kehidupan sehari-hari. Moto dari Art of Living adalah menciptakan perdamaian dalam diri kita, rumah kita, lingkungan, dan selanjutnya mencakup seluruh dunia. Akhir dari kata kami, kami ucapkan terima kasih pada seluruh masyarakat Bali dan bapak-bapak yang memberi waktu untuk kehadiran pada acara ini, upacara suci ini. Terima kasih. Terima kasih. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
You know, Indonesia, especially Bali, has been an example of communal harmony in the world. That Hindus, Muslims, Buddhists, all live in such harmony. Ramayana and Mahabharata are being played in Muslim homes, and Muslims are welcome in Hindu. It is such a harmony between different traditions, and I wish you continue the same tradition, show to the world as an example of how mutual participation in each other's culture will only enrich each other's culture. This is a very good example of harmony in diversity, and I wish you all the best, and let's all pray that this planet of ours, which we consider one family, the whole world to us is one family. This one family lives in harmony, move to higher states of consciousness, move towards sannyasa vidyasa, move towards that highest knowledge, higher form of awareness, and we'll all rejoice in that thought. We all part of sannyasa vidyasa, we all part of that infinite knowledge and divinity. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Terima kasih.
Your Holiness Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, Bapak Mangku Pastika, selamat sebagai calon Gubernur Bali, semoga sukses. Ketua Yayasan Seni Kehidupan Indonesia, yang kami hormati Bapak Gede Prama, para undangan dan hadirin yang kami hormati pula, Om Swastiastu. Mengawali sambutan ini, marilah kita bersama-sama memanjatkan puji syukur kehadapan Tuhan Yang Maha Esa, Ide Sang Yang Widiwasa, atas kertawarunugrahanya kita dapat berkumpul di sini dalam keadaan sehat walafiat untuk mengikuti kegiatan Dharma Yatra untuk melestarikan alam Indonesia dengan tradisi bersama Satguru Sri Sri Rapi Sangkar hari ini Sabtu 19 April 2008. Hadirin yang saya hormati, manusia sebagai penghuni alam ternyata banyak mengikuti hukum alam. Begitu pula dalam evolusinya, manusia dengan daya tahunya serta daya capainya tidak menyerah pada alam yang mengelilingi dia. Manusia bertindak dalam alam, bertindak dengan pengetahuan. Ia hendak mencapai sesuatu. Manusia berada dalam dunia alam sehingga manusia ingin mengolah alam atau dunia. Manusia dalam mengolah alam hendaknya tidak mengeksploitasi alam demi kepentingan keduniawian. Tetapi mengolah alam dengan menjaga hubungan keselarasan. Di Bali dalam sejumlah sastra, manusia diwajibkan melakukan yajna terutama kepada alam raya yang diidentikkan dengan badan Tuhan. Jika alam tidak seimbang dan harmonis, maka manusia akan mengalami kesenjangan iman. Hadirin yang berbahagia, berkenaan dengan interaksi manusia dengan lingkungannya, manusia memiliki gambaran tertentu tentang lingkungan hidupnya yang disebut citra lingkungan. Citra lingkungan merupakan anggapan orang mengenai struktur lingkungan. Bagaimana lingkungan itu berfungsi, reaksinya terhadap tindakan manusia, serta hubungan manusia dengan lingkungannya. Citra lingkungan pada masyarakat modern lebih banyak dilandasi oleh pengetahuan ilmiah, sedangkan pada masyarakat tradisional lebih banyak dilandasi oleh kepercayaan atau mistik. Meskipun citra lingkungan pada masyarakat tradisional sering terkesan tidak logis atau tidak rasional, namun di dalamnya terkandung prinsip dan praktek pengelolaan lingkungan yang baik, yang pada dasarnya merupakan suatu bentuk kearifan ekologi sebagai salah satu aktualisasi dalam menjaga hubungan manusia dengan alamnya. Hadirin yang saya hormati, dalam masyarakat Hindu di Bali terdapat suatu upacara keagamaan yang ditujukan pada kekuatan alam beserta isinya. Tumpek Uduh atau Warige adalah salah satu upacara otonan terhadap tumbuh-tumbuhan. Secara sepintas, kepercayaan seperti ini tidak masuk akal. Namun sebenarnya dapat dibenarkan secara ilmiah karena merupakan mekanisme yang efektif untuk menjaga sumber daya alam. Hal itu didasari pula oleh adanya suatu kepercayaan bahwa hubungan Buana Agung makrokosmos dan Buana Alit mikrokosmos harus tetap terjaga dengan baik jika manusia tidak ingin terjadi bencana oleh alamnya sendiri. Hadirin yang berbahagia, untuk menjaga keselarasan hubungan manusia dengan alam lingkungannya, hendaknya dipertahankan kearifan ekologi dan hendaknya manusia memandang alam sebagai karma bumi. Alam adalah tempat untuk menumbuhkan rasa kebersamaan dan keharmonisan hidup. Dengan adanya kegiatan Dharma Yatra untuk melestarikan alam Indonesia dengan tradisi yang diprakarsai oleh Yayasan Seni Kehidupan Indonesia yang hari ini dapat menghadirkan bersama kita Yang Mulia Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, saya atas nama pribadi dan Wali Kota Denpasar mengucapkan terima kasih dan penghargaan yang sebesar-besarnya atas terselenggaranya kegiatan ini. Hadirin yang saya hormati, demikian yang dapat kami sampaikan. Semoga kegiatan ini dapat berjalan dengan baik dan sesuai dengan yang direncanakan. Damai di hati dan damai di bumi. Om Santi 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 Om. Wali Kota Denpasar, Puspa Yoga.
Om Swastiastu. Singin nabe sane banget sugihan-sugihan Bapak Wali Kota yang sangat saya hormati. Begitu juga Bapak Kandidat Maju Pasdite. Semoga berhasil untuk memegang Bali dengan fundament spiritual. Bapak-bapak dan ibu para hadirin yang kami hormati, kita sangat berbangga kedatangan guru besar Satguru untuk kita berdoa bersama-sama. Thank you, Bu. Terima kasih pancaran cinta kasih terhadap diri kepada sesama. Marilah kita selalu berdoa, memanjatkan berdoa kepada Ide Sang Yang Widiwasa, pencipta jagat raya. Jadi marilah kita satukan diri kita dengan alam semesta ini. Sebetulnya hidup ini adalah indah. Jadi kenapa kita selalu susah? Jadi saya di asrama selalu mengajak anak-anak gembira. Marilah kita berdoa dengan cara kita adalah mengucapkan syukur kepada Tuhan dengan senyum pagi, senyum siang, dan senyum malam. Jadi marilah kita hiasi hidup ini dengan senyum. Jadi hatinya yang tertinggi adalah cinta kasih. Memberi senyum kepada diri sendiri, memberi senyum kepada sesama. Jadi dunia ini akan betul-betul damai. Hanya sekian dari saya sebagai Wakil Panitia. Saya ucapkan terima kasih dan selamat datang kepada Tri Narasapa. Thank you.
Bapak Made Mangkopakstika and Bapak Ratu Bagus to come on stage to receive a token from His Holiness. Disilakan kepada Bapak Aryane, Bapak Mangkopakstika dan Ide Pandita Ratu Bagus, termasuk juga Ketua Sabewalake PHDI Pusat, untuk menerima buku terjemahan dari Satguru Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. Buku ini tersedia di Divine Shop dan akan diberikan diskon khusus dengan atau bukan diskon tapi harga spesial price untuk malam ini. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are interested to own a copy of these books, it will be available at the Divine Shop at a very special promo price only for today.
That's the beautiful greeting in Bali. Om Swasti Rastu. It says it all. Swasti means one to be established in the self. Swa means self, asti means being in oneself. The big self, the higher self. Swasti also means physically, mentally, emotionally and spiritually sound, healthy. So swasti is swast means health. Swasti in Sanskrit means to be healthy mentally, spiritually and physically. So it's a wonderful greeting. Om Swasti Rastu. May God keep everyone healthy. Keep you healthy, keep me healthy, keep the whole planet healthy. In India we say Namaste. Namaste means this is not mine, it's all His. Nothing is mine, it all belongs to God. I belong to God, you belong to God, everything belongs to God. Namaste. It is wonderful to be here with you all. It is wonderful to be with you all here. Especially the chief priest and all the heads of different institutions, the priest, head priest, the governor of Bali and the mayor of Bali, honorable mayor. And I appreciate the beautiful welcome you have given to the Art of Living and all the international community here. You know, it's always a joy to come and be here in Bali. The old ancient civilization is still so alive. We have kept this ancient civilization alive in spite of all modernization. And I encourage you to keep this tradition going. It is vital for the world heritage. As I was listening to the mayor, honorable mayor, talk about how the microcosm and macrocosm is so united, I just want to tell you that yesterday we talked about the same. The first talk I gave yesterday in our advanced course here in the campus, I said that we are all united, everything is united here. Microcosm has an impact on the macrocosm. The scientists do say, agree with what you are saying from thousands of years. That a little act here has an impact on the entire environment, on the entire cosmos. So we have to care for the environment, as you have rightly mentioned. It's so important now that we preserve the environment, not become too greedy. Economic advancement should go hand in hand with protecting the nature. And to protect the nature, we have to create awareness among everybody, youngsters as well as the elderly people, older generation. Yeah? The highest expression
expression of consciousness or divinity in Balinese language is called Sanya Sa Vidya. Vidya, na? Vidyasa. Sanya Sa Vidyasa. I was just looking at the Sanskrit origin of the Sanya Sa Vidyasa. You know, Sanya means in Sanskrit the sign or the highest expression of truth. Vidyasa means the highest expression of knowledge. Highest sign of God, the sign of God is knowledge. Sign of God is knowledge. Sanyasa Vidyasa. Vidyasa, that she is, he is knowledge. That is, every atom in this creation is filled with knowledge. You know, we speak on the phone, but what are we doing? Well, some words are coming out of our mouth, and that little cell phone or even this mic translating that into electrical energy. This energy goes and hits the other receiver, another cell phone. In that cell phone, this energy is translated back into the same words that you are speaking. Means that energy which of your talk which got converted into electricity, when it travels, it is carrying the same sound, same energy with it, same knowledge with it. If that is not the case, you speak something, that energy becomes electricity, it can all get distorted and become something else. It doesn't happen. A television tower relays some knowledge, relays some program, and they throw it in the sky, and the receiver said they catch the same thing. That means the universe carries the same knowledge which you remit to it. It carries that same knowledge and brings you back. This mechanism was known to the ancient people. They said every atom in the creation is filled with knowledge. The empty space that you feel around is not empty, it is full. Jnana Ghan, Satchidananda Jnana Ghan. It is truth, it's consciousness, and it is full of energy and knowledge. The energy is full of knowledge. So every atom, every vibration, every wave of energy in itself carries all the knowledge. And that is exactly Sanyasa Vidyasa. The highest spirit or the space or divinity, God, is full of knowledge. Isn't that beautiful? I really congratulate people of Bali who have maintained this tradition for thousands and thousands of years. They have done a better job than India. In Balinese tradition, they honor the nature. So also in India, it says God is not present somewhere in the heaven. God is in his own creation. He is part of his creation. Honoring God's creation is honoring God. If you honor the mountain, river, and people, and animals, and plants, you are honoring the maker of them all. Dancing divinity. I wish the whole world listened to this. The entire world have to understand, we cannot exploit our river, mountains and people, we have to honor each other. This is the message from the ancient tradition of the world. In fact, all the ancient tradition in the world honors the nature. It's only the modern generation which is exploiting the nature. You know, if you have to cut a tree, you should first promise that tree that you will plant 5 of the same kind before you cut a tree. This is the ancient tradition. The Hindu tradition, one has to take the permission from a tree before you fell a tree. We have to bring back that awareness in the society now. Don't you think so? I would urge the governor of Bali and the mayor to ban chemicals into the island of Bali. Harmful chemicals should not be brought inside. Everything should be organic here. I don't know how you will do it, but step by step I'm sure you can devise plans to see that these islands, all these islands are free from chemical pollution. You know, there are number of hotels here, so many tourists come. They should all use only the soaps and shampoos and all this which is free from natural chemical disaster. You know, should be organic, natural, not, they should not have any harmful chemicals that the soil can never process it. The Balinese people are smiling all the time. As our chief priest said in his talk, they say, thank God with a smile in the morning and thank God smile in the evening with a smile. So this is the best form of prayer. When you pray to God, you have to smile and thank. You know? I'm sure Art of Living has the same principle. Everybody smiles more. The graduation of Art of Living is that you are smiling more and more and more and make everyone else smile more and more. And there are hundreds of youths here, Balinese youths have taken advantage of Art of Living, Sudarshan Kriya. I want many of them to become teachers soon. We don't have many teachers here. I think one or two teachers are working day and night. I welcome them to come to India. Of course, India is the hub of yoga and Vedic knowledge. And Balinese do have that, know that, and great reverence for India as well. So the yajna means coming together of knowledge, action, and devotion. Knowledge, action and devotion coming together forms the yajna. And in Bali you are having these yajnas time and again. And this is one such yajna where we have all come together, celebrate, and I wish we will have more and more of this happening at least once every year. I was also thinking maybe once we should have a pranayama and meditation and health and happiness workshop for all the Balinese people here, 2 or 3 days. 2 or 3 days, 2 or 3 evenings, everybody can do pranayama and, you know, and yoga, pranayama, meditation. This will help one maintain the health and happiness, of course. You know. Health, happiness. You know, when the economic growth happens in any part of the world, along with that comes stress. Along with stress comes physical illnesses and mental disturbances. Our aim is to have a violence-free society, of course, which is already here in Bali, to maintain that violence-free atmosphere. You need to have a disease-free body, confusion-free mind, inhibition-free intellect, trauma-free memory and a sorrow-free soul. And pranayama, sudarshan kriya, naturally provides us all this. I understand that many of the priests here also did the sudarshan kriya and they enjoyed the process very much. And I would welcome some of the priests also to take the teacher's training, and you can help all those who come here. People need this knowledge. Shall we do a short meditation? And I answer, there are very great scholars here. I would like to know more about the Balinese culture and traditions. Sometime we would like you to speak on these. You know, and people are very interested. They want interested to see all the concepts, and the tradition. You know, understanding has its own joy. It has its own elevation of spirit.
Bye. Thank you.